I got a new camera, and now you can see every imperfection on my face. This was a bad idea. Best Catholic Music of 2017. First, I have to give an honorable mention to Mike Mangione and the Kinz, But I've Seen the Stars. First off, that's an amazing album title. But I've Seen the Stars came out late last year, and I have massive respect for Mike Mangione, his music, and his podcast, Time in the Mystery with Mike Mangione. And it gets honorable mention this year, mostly for like very subjective reasons, and I'll get to that in a minute. But the best music that I listened to that was made by a Catholic this year was David Ramirez's We're Not Going Anywhere. I was listening to this album on repeat basically since September when it came out. I really love this album, partially because like the whole thing is kind of about something, like a specific story that's something that's happening in David's life and broader idea about what it means to live in America now that it's 16 years after 9/11. I'm not just pulling that out of nowhere. The first song of the album is called Twins. Where Were You When We Lost the Twins? Honestly, the best 9/11 song since Alan Jackson, Where Were You When the World Stopped Turning? Only this song is about all the disorientation that has also happened in the 16 years since then. We have soldiers fighting in Iraq whose fathers fought in Iraq. The album kind of has this weird quality of meandering for a little bit, but every time it meanders, it's a really, really good song. Lots of drinking in this album. Lots of drinking on a Tuesday on this album. Just Tuesday is the day one gets drunk if you're David Ramirez, apparently. And then halfway through the album, it busts out the song Stone Age, the protest song. Angry Gen X, the world's gone down the toilet and it's everyone else's fault. And what am I supposed to do with my life now? What people complain about nowadays song. And it's weird because the song is both kind of heavy-handed, but also kind of earned the right to be heavy-handed. It's just wonderful. Another Drunk on a Tuesday song, by the way. This album spends one, maybe two songs lamenting and protesting, lashing out against the state of affairs in the country and in our world. It spends eight songs lamenting and lashing out against the state of affairs within David Ramirez. This is how you become a good protester, a good protest songwriter. All of the greatest protest songwriters, Bob Dylan's, the Nina Simone's of this world, they knew the very first and most important step of changing the broader world is to change what's going on inside of us, to address what's going on inside of us. Change that has to happen, or at least just the poetry of experiencing it. For every young gifted in black, there's I Wish I Knew How It Would Feel to Be Free and a Sinner Man. And for every blown in the wind, there's a Boots of Spanish Leather and a North Country Blues. And Dave Ramirez nailed it. The whole album is just stewing what's wrong and what needs to change and what's happened to me, what I've done to others. It's a really great brooding on the things that are bad album, which makes it a great 2017 album. That's mostly what I did most of 2017. You might have been different, but that's what happened to me, which is why like Mike Mangione's a great album. Didn't do the same thing I did. So my subjective opinion is Dave Ramirez's best of 2017. This might say more about me than the music, but it's my vlog. If you have different opinions, then start your own. Dave Ramirez, We're Not Going Anywhere, is the best album made by a Catholic in 2017. And I'm really looking forward to 2018, by the way. Everyone is in the studio right now making music. This is good. Rabble's the MC, slowly making it so that Catholic rap is no longer a punchline. Thank God. Audrey Asada's in the studio. Ike Ndolo's in the studio. I've been waiting for this Honor Flow Productions album for like 2 years. Let's be honest, Christian rap peaked with Ooh Ah by Grits like 20 years ago, and it's never been able to recover. And on the Christian music side of things, Derek Webb and John Mark McMillan came out with albums this year. Christian rock is weird again. Real question is, who did I miss? What was an album made by a Catholic that came out this year that I should have put on this video? I wanna know. I like music, so I wanna hear the music you have. Go ahead, argue about it in the comments. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you hit the notification button. Make sure you tell your friends. Make sure you do all those things so that more Steve the Missionary videos can come out. I will see you next time. My life be like ooh ah, ooh ah, mm, my life be like ooh ah, ooh ah, ooh.